Years before the grand discoveries of Darwin, it was believed that all life had been placed on Earth in their complete perfection by God. Today, it is accepted as scientific fact that life is forever changing, moving, and making itself better through evolution. Today, we will look at three examples that will prove the existence of evolution. The finches Darwin inspected on the Galapagos Islands showed that not every individual in a species is exactly the same. This is called variation. It explains why the finches' beaks had changed to fit the diet available on the different islands. The rock pocket mouse of Arizona's Penacardi Desert has undergone a similar phenomenon. Typically, these mice have light-colored fur that suits well for blending into the sandy desert. Unfortunately for these mice, volcanic activity has changed the color of parts of the desert to dark gray. On these dark gray rocks, white-colored mice are easily spotted by predators. Scientists discovered that mice living on the dark rock had developed darker fur. This was due to a chance mutation in the genetic coding. Comparing the DNA showed that the light and dark furred mice had the same DNA, except for in four places. When a mutation occurs in those four spots, a change in the color of the fur happens, allowing that mouse to blend in and live on the dark rock. This is natural selection in action. While the light mice are picked off easily on the dark rock, the mutated mouse blended in. It survived its predators and was able to pass that trait onto its offspring. Eventually, all the mice that lived on the darker rock had dark fur. They were the ones best suited to their environment. This proves that evolution is slowly occurring with every mutation in the DNA code. The fact that the same species was steadily changing makes the concept of evolution easier to grasp. It was hard enough for people of Darwin's time to comprehend the fact that humans and apes shared a common ancestor. But our ties to other animals goes far beyond that. Humans, like all four-limbed animals, descended from fish. Similar structures in human and fish embryos proves this fact. Prehistoric fish, Tiktaalik, had the same bone structure in their fin-like arms as all modern-day land animals. Scientists theorize that this must have allowed them to escape onto land away from predators. Today's paddlefish are one of the last survivors of Tiktaalik's immediate family tree. Hox genes are found in all complex animals. The letters that make up this gene have remained almost unchanged throughout history. Analyzing the DNA of paddlefish is the closest scientists can get to analyzing a real Tiktaalik. Hox genes are absolutely crucial to the body structure of an animal. The same Hox genes that control the large branch of cartilage in a fish's fin controls the big bone in land animals' arms. Another set of Hox genes controls the growth of two forearm bones, or cartilage, in both. The same genes make the smaller fragments at the end. A few changes to these genes have made all the difference in life's transition to land from sea. There is a 1% DNA difference between chimps and humans. How could one be Earth's dominant species and the other be nowhere close? One difference between us is in humans' nimble, dexterous hands. But science are not confused how animals so different could be alike, but rather how two animals so alike can be so different. Scientists have discovered that there is a glitch in every human's genome. This glitch takes place in the muscle-making gene. This means that we chew at just a fraction of the force of other apes. However, all of an ape's muscle power puts limits on how much a brain can grow, because it forces the skull to accommodate for the massive muscles that move the jaw. A mutation in our jaw muscles allowed human skulls to grow into adulthood to make room for our large brains to grow. It is astounding the progress the human race has made. Who would have thought that a key component in the human rise to the top of the planet would be a glitch in our jaw muscle? It just goes to show, one, the immense power of evolution and the grand outcomes it can lead to.